Hello, Purple Banditos, and welcome back to more Let's Play Pokemon Emerald. I'm Purple Rodri. Last time we caught the legendary Pokemon Groudon by going through different routes and finding where it was. Today we're going to do pretty much the same thing, but actually go after Kyogre. Once again, we're going to be making our way to the Weather Institute, and from there we'll be able to figure out where exactly Kyogre is hiding. Another thing we're going to need is, you guys will see, we need a special HM and all sorts of things. So let's go ahead and make our way up here and then figure it out. Also, I'm going to go ahead and refresh you guys. As I mentioned before, for Groudon and Kyogre, there are four separate routes and two locations in each route that where you can find the Pokemon. So I'll go ahead and see if I can show you guys both. As you can see, there seems to be a crazy rainstorm in Route 127. So that's where we're gonna have to go today. Route 127 is actually one of the more difficult ones to find Kyogre. So yay, fantastic. Of course that would happen to me. Whoop-de-dee-doo, we have to go through the most difficult route. Now I'm actually going to make my way right now to Lily Cove because, oh, and also, still trained up our Pokemon. They're at the same level that they were with Groudon, so no worries, they haven't changed. But we're gonna go to Lily Cove City because I need to remove Surf off of Katara so I can teach it Dive, because we're actually gonna need Dive in order to find Kyogre. Kyogre's hiding in some weird underground chamber somewhere, and we're really just gonna have to go and look for it. So let's go ahead and try that. Let's go ahead and remove Surf then. Such a good move too. I kind of hate the fact that you can only know four moves on a Pokemon. I wish you could know like five, maybe six. You know, it would make things so much easier. But then I'm sure there would be like one Pokemon that can learn every single HM, like a Zigzagoon, and then he'd just have every single HM on there and he'd just be like, oh, a total boss. Like you wouldn't even need anything else. All right, so Route 127 is near Moss Deep City. Let's go ahead and make our way there then and see if we can find it. I hope you guys are having a nice day. My day's okay. As I mentioned to you guys in the last video, you know, going through a little bit of a tough time, but I'm trying my best to push through. I also want to give you guys a big thanks to all of you guys who actually left comments and who sent me messages, and you guys just don't know how much that means to me. I really appreciate it, and it honestly, like, it does help a lot, so I just want to give you guys a big thanks. A lot of you guys opened up to me, too, about things that you've been going through and things you've been going through in your life, and, you know, thank you. Like, I'm always going to be here for you if you guys need it. I always try to just give back a little, you know, even if my day isn't as shiny and sunny as when Groudon is out, you know, sometimes like I still am going to try to give back and just give a positive message. So maybe, you know, if I'm not even having a great day, in some way it'll help you guys. And that's what I'm trying to do. Like I said, if I can just get a smile out of one of you guys, it makes it all worth it. And it really does. It really does make it worth it. You know, there's little moments where I was playing League of Legends and I had a viewer message me and he was like 8 or 10 or something like that. And he was like, oh, hey, like, is Elsa potty trained? And then he went ahead and told me how he had like 4 fish and 7 birds. And it's just it was cute. You know, it was kind of like, you know, a little guy's watching me. And it's just kind of cool that people like that, like, look up to me and just, you know, I just really appreciate it. And honestly, like, it really makes me thankful for life. It really makes me appreciate every aspect of it. And I'm just blessed to have the chance to talk to you guys and to tell you these dumb jokes and tell you stories and try to give you some advice and, you know, try to help you out with life a little bit, because you guys really helped me out. So it's a big thanks to you guys. It's just something that really means a lot to me, and I want to thank you guys for that. All right, I'm going to go ahead and teach Dive to Katara then, and we're going to continue on. And we're actually really close to the place where you saw earlier where I was, where the fishermen were. That's where the first spot is that Rayquaza or that Kyogre could be here in Route 127. Today, I'm actually going to go, or right now, I'm actually going to go to the other spot. Sometimes the diving spots only show up if the Pokemon's there. As you could see earlier, Kyogre wasn't there, so the diving spot wasn't there. That's how I knew to come to this spot, which is a little bit hidden. It's a little strange spot. It almost looks like a spot where a special event would take place, you know, something like that. Now, you can see the diving spot is right here. It won't appear here. I don't even think you can get here unless you're looking for Kyogre. So there you go, special spot for you guys that you've never seen before. Let's make our way inside the cave then and see if Kyogre truly is here. I know that Kyogre is going to be a tough Pokemon to catch, but I'm kind of excited. Man, it's kind of chilly in here. Maybe it's because we're in a cave. Well, I don't know. I guess you could call my office a cave. All right, guys, we're in the Marine Cave, and this is where Kyogre is going to be. I'm going to go ahead and save, and I'll be back with you guys in a couple seconds. Okay, guys, so I've gone ahead and saved, and we are ready to take on Kyogre. There it is. Wow, that thing is pretty huge, too. So get ready. because here we go, Rodri versus Kyogre. Let's go ahead and take on the third legendary Pokemon of the Hoenn region. We've already took on the other two, so let's go ahead and beat this one as well. I think we're going to do a great job on it, and let's see what we can do. Let's make some magic happen. As you can see, I actually have Goat up in front. I have some strategies in mind. I know that Goat will pretty much be able to tank everything except the water or the Hydro Pump. I'm pretty sure Kyogre has Hydro Pump, Rest, Double Edge, and one other move, which is like a Hail Freeze or something like that. Some one-hit KO, like Ice-type, Water-type move. Something like that. And it's strange that it's already going to sleep. You know, one of the easiest way to catch these Pokemon is actually when they're asleep. I don't know how much the chance to catch them goes up, but it goes up by a lot. So if you can actually throw a Pokeball at it when you have it in the yellow and it's asleep, I highly recommend that. I mean, that's what we did with Rayquaza, and we actually seem to catch it a lot easier. All right, guys, let's see what we can do here. I'm kind of excited to finally catch this Pokemon, because with that, we'll finally have the big figureheads of, you know, the Hoenn region. We'll have Rayquaza, we'll have Kyogre, and then we'll have Groudon. I know that they're... I mentioned to you guys earlier that I've never really caught the Regis. Regirock, Regice, Registeel. So we'll definitely be doing that. I have decided we are going to be going after them very soon. We also have to go after Latias now because I chose the red on the news reporter. And then after that, there are a couple special event Pokemon which I'm going to try to do, which I think could be a lot of fun because it's something I've never really done. You know, it's kind of cool when I have the chance to actually go through a game, whether it's, you know, Sinnoh or Kalos or, you know, whatever it is, it's kind of, or Unova, it's kind of cool that I get the chance to do some special events and things like that where, like, you know, not many people have seen them. I don't think too many people have done the events. I don't know, if you're like me, I never really went to wherever it is to do the special events. It just kind of blew my mind. It just kind of, like, you know, came in one way, went out the other. So I never really had the chance to do them. So whenever I get the chance to actually do them, it's like a new experience, you know? It's like a new level to Pokemon to kind of have to check that out and to go ahead and, like, go through a new place and find an item and see a little bit more of the story. And it's just kind of cool. All right, well, we have Kyogre in the red zone. This thing is really not going down. As you can see, it just tried to use that move on me. That's the one-hit KO. I don't know how it works. I think it's kind of like Fisher. And Fisher is what Groudon has, and I think you have to be a certain, like, a certain amount of levels below the Pokemon or something of that sort in order to catch it, or I mean in order to use the move. Maybe it's like 5 or 6 levels, I really don't know, or maybe the Pokemon has to be the same level as you. I think that's what it is, something like that, like they can't be levels under you or some sort of thing like that. If you know, you know what I'm talking about. And the move's kind of crazy, a one-hit KO move. Now, I've never been big in competitive battling or anything, but you think that would be, like, really helpful. You know, you think moves like that would be just, like, completely crazy. You know, you just one-hit KO everything and just knock it out. I remember when I was younger and I had Pokemon Yellow, one of the Pokemon that I really liked was a Nidoking, and he was, like, really high level, probably, like, 70, 75, 80, something like that. I don't know. I haven't played my Yellow in years. And he was just like a really high level Pokemon. And I remember he had the move like Horn Drill, I think it was. One of those one hit KO moves. And I just thought, like, man, this guy is the bomb. Like a one hit KO move? What kind of crazy Pokemon learns that? You know, it was just really cool, like, back in the day that even in Yellow, they had such a crazy strong move. And back then, it was just like mind blowing. I guess nowadays, things are a little bit different. There are Pokemon that are so much more stronger than a Nidoking, and there are so much better moves, but back then, like, that was the bomb. Like, you had, like, Ice Beam. On my Mewtwo, I think I had, like, Ice Beam, Tri-Attack, Psychic, and, like, Rest. And I'm pretty sure that was my moveset. I'm almost 100% sure that was my moveset. And that was, like, the bomb. I for some reason, when I was a kid, you know, the whole rock, paper, scissors thing, like, fire, water, grass, whatever it is, like, the little triangle, I used to think, like, Tri-Attack actually used a little power from each three. I don't know if it really does, honestly. I never looked into it back then in that gen, but I used to think, like, oh, it uses a little bit every time, like, this thing shoots a little bit of fire, shoots a little bit of water, shoots a little bit of grass, a little bit of electric, because it looked like electric. And I just thought, like, Tri-Attack was, like, one of the strongest moves, and it looked so freaking cool, and it was, like, black and white on the screen and everything, but I thought it was, like, one of the strongest moves, and it was just, like, so amazing and so cool. I'm pretty sure, like, it really wasn't that good of a move. I probably had, like, 60 base power or something like that, something, like, kind of low, something of that sort. But I don't know, back in the day when I was a kid, You know, that was, it was cool for me. And that's how, like, that's how simple and innocent those things were back in the day. Like, I would just be like, oh, tri-attack, like, what an awesome move. Horn drill, awesome. Like, ice beam, the bomb. And it was just kind of cool, like, that I had that. I think I had an ice beam on Nidoking, too. So Nidoking and Mewtwo were, like, my two big, you know, bosses. Like, they carried everything, and they just did everything they could. With that, guys, we have caught Kyogre. So that was actually pretty fast. That didn't take too long. And with that, we're going to go ahead and actually give Kyogre a nickname as well. So let's go ahead and give Kyogre this nickname. Kyogre is a sea-basin Pokemon. Its height is 14 foot 9. Weight is 776 pounds. Kyogre has appeared in mythology as the creator of the sea after long years of feuding with Groudon, took to sleep at the bottom of the sea. So with that, let's go ahead and give it a nickname then. And I am going to go ahead and call this Pokemon something, you know, if Rayquaza was verde, if Groudon was rojo, I think you guys might know what this is. And we're going to go ahead and call Kyogre Azul, which means blue in Spanish. With that, it has been transferred to the PC, and it looks like we are done here, guys. I don't have any escape ropes. I know, I forgot to buy them. What am I doing with my life? I kind of forgot, you know, split-second decision, forgot to buy it. It's all good, though. So let's go ahead and get out of this cave then. Next time, you know, we will be continuing on catching legendary Pokemons. I haven't really decided who we're gonna go after next. I guess I kind of have to figure that out. There's a lot of Pokemon legendaries to catch in this game, so it's kind of just up to me, I guess, what kind of decision. I don't know, maybe leave me a comment, let me know which Pokemon you want me to catch next, which legendary you want me to catch next. But for now, the massive downpour is gone. Let's go ahead and make our way to Lily Cove then, because I think I'm gonna get rid of Dive on Katara and give it Surf again. I think that's probably for the best. So with that, guys, you know, stay strong. Thanks for always being there for me. If you guys have any tips on what's coming up, let me know. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.